नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 8, हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिजम्स रिप्रोड्यूस। ओके, सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। नाउ टुडे वी डिस्कस रिप्रोडक्शन इन द human beings. So you know that the reproduction in the human beings takes place, say human beings or humans use sexual mode of reproduction. See, you already learned the asexual reproduction, and different organisms use the different modes of sexual reproductions. But here in the sexual reproduction, you know that male gamete and female gamete should fuse together, then forms zygote. From the zygote, the new ones develops, or young ones develops. See, let us begin an apparently unrelated point like this. All of us, you know that our bodies start changing as we become older. So you know that when you go on, our bodies changes. You also learned that changes that takes place in our body from the beginning. We notice that our height has increased continuously from early age till now. And you know that, you see, there are stages in the lives. The child stage, afterwards young, then becomes adolescent age, then slowly changes into adult size. Okay, so you know that our teeth, we acquire teeth, even losing the old teeth, so-called milk teeth, then acquires the new ones. So these are the changes commonly taking place in the childhood. And all of these changes that can be grouped under the general process of growth. So these are all the indicates the process of growth in which the body becomes larger. The process of growth indicates the body becomes larger. But in the early teenage, when you start from the 13, 14, 15, so like this, these are all teenagers we are saying, a whole new set of changes occurs that cannot be explained simply as a body enlargement. So here you cannot say by only body enlargement, by this word is not enough here. Instead, here what changes still again will be there. The appearance of the body changes, the body appearance, proportions will be changes, new features appear, and so do new sensations also. So these are the things here, these are the developments, or these are the changes we will observe. So what are the changes? The appearance of the body changes, proportions will be changes according to the body proportions, new features appears to the both, and new sensation also will build up in that stage. See, some of these changes are common to both the boys and girls. The changes that can be grouped in which the body becomes larger, after that, some of the changes that are common to both the boys and girls. So what are those? You will see, we begin to notice thick hair growing in the new parts of the body, such as armpits and the genital area. So here what are changes? Changes take place that are different between the boys. Here you will see that, notice that thick hair growing in the new parts of the body, such as armpits and as well as the genital area between the thighs, which can also become darker in the color. Thinner hair also appears. See, feeder also can appear on the legs and arms. So these are the changes you are observing, as well as on the face. The skin frequently becomes oily, and we might be begin to develop pimples. So pimples noticing on the face. And we are very conscious about our bodies, aware of both opposite sex on their own bodies and those of other bodies. So these are the feelings and developments or changes noticing in this stage. So this you are seeing puberty, you are seeing. Okay, in the adolescence period, these are the observations we form. And now you will see the secondary changes. What are the secondary changes? See, there are also changes takes place that are different between the boys and girls. You know that in the girls, the breech size begins to increase with the darkening of the skin at the nipples, at the tip of the breech. And also girls begins to start with the menstruation cycle. So this is about the boys. Sorry, this is about the girls. But in the boys, begins to have new thick hair growth on the face. And their voices begin to crack. Some harsh voice starts. And further, the penis begins to become enlarged. So this is about the in the boys. Okay. So these are all, so asking the question, write the secondary sexual characters, boys as well as girls. And although of these changes takes place slowly, not at a regular, this of changes takes place immediately, not slowly, over a period of months or over a years. They do not happen all at the same time. But you don't think like that, see, the 13 years only, not. It may be, depends upon the person to persons and later. And this, they do not happen at the whole same time in one person. They happen at the exact age. In some people, they happen early or quickly, while in other, they may slowly. Okay. And each changes does not become completely quickly either. Say that it may not be completely quickly either. So, for example, thick hair on the face, the voice appears a few scattered hairs first and only slowly goes growth begin to become uniform. So like this indication. In all these changes show the difference between the people to people or person to persons. Okay. So, for example, we are having different noses or different fingers. So like this, different patterns of the hair growth or size. So like this will be, some of them may be earlier, some of them may be late, but all these changes are slowly changes take place. So this we are calling the puberty, we are saying. So what is the meaning of the puberty definition? The age at which the reproduction organs becomes functional. The age at which the reproduction organ becomes functional. So that is called as puberty. Okay, this puberty, what? The age become functional. Okay, so how do all these changes, what we are talking about, linked to the reproductive process? You must remember that the sexual mode of reproduction means the germ cells forms two individuals that have to join together. Okay, germ cells should produce. This can happen by the external release of the germ cells from the bodies of the both the individuals, or it happens in the transfer germ cells and to the ear, male and female should mating here, even mating. The body should contact. Their state of sexual maturity must be indefinable by the other individuals. So many changes during the puberty, such as a new hair growth patterns, are the signals of sexual reproduction is taking place. So they are fit for the sexual reproduction. Okay, this is about the sexual reproduction. Now you will see the male reproductive system. See, male reproductive system. The male reproductive system consists of portion which produce germ cells and the other portion that deliver the germ cells to the site of fertilization. So you know that the important organs, the important parts will be in the male reproductive system. The testes. The testes are two in numbers. This is the main organ producing the sperm, releasing the sperm. And this testes, sperm should pass through the vas deferens, through the small pipe you see. And this will join to the urethra. Through the urethra, sperm and urine both will be passed through it. So you know that in the testes, the structure what will be there? In the testes, tube-like structures that contains. That is, we are saying semi-ferrous tubules. In this, sir, sperm formation takes place. So, the formation of germ cells and sperms taking place in the testes. See, the formation of germ cells or sperms that takes place in the testes, these are located outside the abdominal cavity. These are outside the abdominal stomach, abdominal cavity, in the scrotum, you know that outside, like there is a bag-like structure. So we are saying scrotum, because so this is outside. Why? Because sperm formation requires a lower temperature than the normal body temperature. So that is why it should be away from the body. So sometimes asking the question, or away from the abdominal cavity, outside the abdominal cavity. Why? Because for the sperm formation, compared to the body temperature, here less temperature required. Okay. So you know that the in the testes produces hormones that you are calling testosterone. What do you think? Testosterone. And this testosterone brings changes in the appearance seen in the boys at the time of puberty. So this testosterone brings the changes or notice the changes at the time of the puberty, at the time of puberty, at the time of the puberty, okay. The sperm spore delivered, and this sperm, you know, they formed, delivered through the vas deferens, which unites with the tube coming to the urinary bladder. And the urethra thus forms a common passage for both the sperms and urine. Okay, in this way, this channel takes place. Okay, like this. Testes, vas deferens, then here what will be there? Ureter, and then the urethra. So like this way, this channel will be there. And along the path of the vas deferens, gland-like other structures will be there. See that. What is that? Prostate gland and seminal vesicle. And this one, their secretions, they will produce somewhat secretions, some of the substances they are releasing. So that the sperms are getting the nutrient. So what will get sperms get? Nutrient will get. Nutrients, and makes the sperms in the liquid medium. And these sperms are tiny bodies, so that will help to move through the female germ cell. Okay, I know that the sperms cells are tiny bodies that consist of mainly genital bodies, that consists of genetic material along the tail and helps them to move towards the female germ cell. So in this way, that helps to move towards the female germ cell. So this is about the male reproductive system. Okay, got the idea, students? So remember, both the questions, how the reproduction takes place in the human beings, and also write the male reproductive system and their parts also. So go through this one, and remaining like female reproductive system and reproductive health, we'll discuss in the next video. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you for joining us.